good, YouTube? It's your boy Dev back again for another first listen. I'm like a plizzang. Today we are going to take a listen to Vince Staples' new project, Big Fish Theory. Now, for me, Vince Staples was a little up and down with me. I know a lot of people really love him. He has a lot of West Coast vibes to him, and like I do like some West Coast songs. Sometimes I feel like the sound can get a little repetitive. That's just me personally. When I listened to Prima Donna, it was like a little short EP. I wasn't really feeling it except like one track. I listened to Summertime 06. It was kind of the same thing. Everybody said Hell Can Wait was way better than that. But Summertime 06 definitely had some bangers. But then there were some songs I really didn't like that a lot of people didn't agree with me with. Mostly Western, you know, Californian people. But that's what we're here for, man. You know, agree to disagree and all that stuff. So I didn't mind it. I took all the backlash. You know, like, I'm always open to him. He's definitely a very interesting artist. Like, he's very woke, you know, knows about what's the surrounding and what's going on and whatnot. So I can't really hate him on that. My favorite song from him being that North Side, Long Beach, North Side. I like that shit, man. That shit catchy as fuck, you know. Like, I be in the car just, motherfucker just, you know, in that bit, head bopping shit. So, Vince Staples, I'm excited to see what he got on this new project right here. 12 tracks. Y'all know how I feel about tracks under 15. And they're all relatively short. So I feel like, you know, we're going to get through right there, right to the point, man. It's going to be nice. You know, I'm going to fuck with it. Hey, but like always, though, been fucking talking too much. Let's get right into this. We got Vince Staples, Big Fish Theory. Y'all ready? All right, we got track one, Crabs in a Bucket. Definitely a very interesting intro. It was just very interesting. Like, I'm sitting here, I'm like, damn, like, why does it sound like I'm in a techno club? You know, I always tell my friends, because I got, like, you know, a couple of my best friends, three of them, they always like, y'all going to that club again? Like, I don't even got a name, so I just like, because you know you be in a club, your ass be on one, you know, whether you smoking, popping, drinking, you know, shooting, whatever you do, I don't know what you do. But then, you know, you hear the sounds, just be, party boy. You know, so that's how I feel like with those sounds, man. I feel like you was at one of them rave clubs and shit like that. So, but definitely a very interesting intro. I did not expect Vince Staples to, you know, mesh that with his West Coast sounds. I did not expect that. That was something different. Okay. Track two, Big Fish. Hey, that's juicy. That right there, definitely good track to bring you in. You know what I'm saying? Like, had those watery sounds though, mixed with that West Coast sound. Like, you know, it meshed very well. I liked it, man. Like, you can hear that flow. Like, it just got that. I don't know, man. Like, you know what I'm saying, man. You know, you from the West. You got that sound. You know, that E40 sound. You know, it was like using those kind of beats. So, I mean, it was a cool track, though. I fucked with it. That was probably a good track to come in, you know, better than the last two projects I listened to from Vince Staples, you know, from the intro. Also, another thing, too, you know, the track name was Big Fish, and then, you know, I had to see Big Fish, and then it had that water sound, so it kind of applied. A big fish in the water, you know? I mean, where the fuck else would a big fish be? Track three, Alyssa's Interlude.
I mean, the stuff I wrote about was only like that.
For that track, I got like a little Outkast vibe from that one, man. Like, that's just some different shit right there. That sound like a Quemini using the synthetics, you know, from there, you know. It sound like a little Quemini feel to it, man. Like, I definitely am fucking with this so far. This is definitely something different than Prima Donna and Summertime 06. You know, more in my lane just because I like this, you know, different sounds. I'm more of a production man myself. You know, I like, you know, to hear different sounds coming together and whatnot. Track 4, Love Can Be. This is not your normal album. Like, this is not your typical Vince Staple project. Like, this is definitely up and beyond. He's definitely, you know, pushing for a different sound here. He's trying something new, and I can't. It definitely sounds very futuristic here. And I mean, I like it personally. I could definitely see why some people wouldn't like it because it's not their flavor. But for me, man, I like sounds like this. Man, I go on SoundCloud all the time. And, you know, find, you know, remixes and mashups and dubsteps like that. Like, I love that shit, man. I love when you mix and you mesh different sounds together. So, I mean, this to me is already, you know, one of his best projects just because of how different it is. So, I mean, that's why I like different. Sometimes different can be good. Sometimes different can be bad. But that's where you take the risk. And no one's successful unless you take risk. And that's just how I feel about that. Track 5, 745. You know what it sounds like? You know, in a dream I run. In a dream I run.
Come in at 7:45. Hope I can't come scoop you up round 7:45.
Ooh.
Sit around with my drop top up or down, you down the rack. Look into my eyes and show the fact. Hope I can't come scoop you up round 7:45.
I gotta tweet this bit. You ain't won.
All my life, pretty women done tell me lies.
Damn, for real.
All my life, pretty women done tell me lies.
Y'all.
7:45.
Bitch.
Hope I can't come sit you up round 7:45.
Bitch.
Slide around with my drop top up on me. Watch out for the snakes, baby. Open streets, ocean breeze. We should get away, baby.
That's probably the best track on this album so far, man. I'm definitely fucking with that one. Like, yo, you heard that shit? Just like, that's, man, y'all know how I feel about them vibes, man. I just be in here just vibing and vibing. And I'm sitting here like, man, this young kind of straight 745. And then, you know, like, he kept the same, like I said, he keep the same West Coast flow. It's just different. It's just a different sound from, you know, that you gotta either like or you gotta dislike. I like sounds like that, man. You know, like I said, like, that shit to me is what I fucks with. I love production. And I, you know, me listening to more music ever than before in this past year, I figured that out for myself. That production for me is top, man. I love production, man. That's one thing of music that I appreciate. So, track 6, Ramona Park is Yankee Stadium. What's funny is he said Ramona Park is Yankee Stadium. I mean, everybody reps they set, you know, everybody reps where they're from, you know, with pride. But I think, you know, Yankee Stadium is just too legendary to be anything but Yankee Stadium, you know. Track 7, yeah, all
right. Yeah, right, yeah, right. Boy, yeah, right, 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 yeah, right, yeah, right.
Ooh.
Boy, yeah, yeah, right. What they know that?
Hey, yeah.
How to live life, how to love life, how to work low. Get your buzz right, get your trap jump, get your jump right, got your head right.
Boy, that voice is stopping. Whoa, that definitely caught me by surprise. First of all, you know, the pussy was slapping. First of all, the pussy was coming at me, and it was just, you know, it was just slapping me in the face. You know, the air just was in the face, bruh. But then, like, the beat changed, and I'm sitting there like, man, what is this shit? Like, this shit is crazy. Like, this sound like, you know, some rock, electronic, metal, / motherfucking techno shit. Like, I'm sitting here like, what the fuck is this? Like, this is some different sound and shit. And I'm like, wait, okay, the beat about to drop, and it's climaxing. I'm sitting here like, okay, we ready. And the next thing you know, like, then K-Dot come in that bitch, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh yeah, talk like New York niggas, dead ass. Dead ass, B, you feel me? So I feel like, man, look, I'm definitely feeling that one. Like, between 745 and Yeah Right, that's tough, man. But K-Dot, you know, having K-Dot on the feature as well, I didn't even expect K-Dot to be there. I was literally shocked, but like, man, hey. 745 still might be my shit, but that Yeah Right was motherfucking thumping. Like, that shit was thumping. Track 8, Homage. Sound like some motherfucking, you know, 32-bit track from Nintendo and shit, you know, 64-bit tracks like that. Y'all know what I'm talking about, man. A little doom, 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 doom. Fucking Donkey Kong tracks and shit. Hey. Okay, got that little Rosé sample in there. Okay. Top me in limbo. Shout out to the Renegon. Shout out to the Renegon, bro. Alright, man. Other than, you know, these hoes won't hold me back. You know, these things, they can't hold me back. The Rick Ross lines there. I mean, I like that. I like the verses. The chorus is a little eh. I like Rick Ross' version better. But, you know, the verses, he was definitely saying some real shit. Production. And there's one thing I can't knock out off this project so far is the production tracks 1-8. Just straight fire on the production. Like, I don't understand. Maybe it's because it's like, you know, Big Fish Theory, you know, like, you got watery sounds. That's the only thing I can connect it with. But I mean, I don't know. I know it's bigger than that, but y'all know who I am, man. I just tell y'all how I feel about it. I'm not really going in there and bitch, but like, decipher shit, you feel me? Like, I'm just listening to the music, enjoying it. But I, you know, it has definitely a lot of watery sound, a lot of techno shit, definitely. You know, a very different Vince Staples that we're usually accustomed to. So I think I like it. I mean, let me know how y'all in the comments if y'all feel right now before y'all listen to the last four tracks with me. How y'all think about it? Like, what do y'all think about what do y'all think about so far about the production? Because I fuck with the production so far. Track 9, Samo. Same old. The West a love song, could I make it bang? If I pull up with my gun drawn, run I make it bang? Only tell me where you come from, tell me what you bang. That the rain, decorating, paint the Spain. Blow the budget on that accent, yeah. With that accent, yeah. Southern keep playing, watch me do the same old thing. Just the same old thing. Bang, 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 bang. Do the same old thing. For me, man, I felt like that track kind of slowed down a little bit. A little bit is for my liking. I mean, I felt it was out of place, if you want me to be real. I think it was out of place. Other than that, though, man, like, I mean, it wasn't too bad. I just think I wasn't in the mood for it. Maybe catch me later. But it was just like, at first it just hit me like, damn, you know, because, you know, it was boom, boom, and it was hitting me. But I'm just sitting here like, okay, now it's a little overwhelming, you know, like it's a little, you know, it's just taking me over a little bit. I ain't really like that. You know, I heard it from those laid back, you know, 8 tracks that we had. Track 10, Party People. And when I mean laid back, I mean just like vibing laid back, not like, you know, slow melody laid back, you know. Yeah, I've been fucked since my early days. I've been stuck in my worldly ways. Propaganda press the track started, I'm like, yo, shit, oh, like, oh, shit, I'm thinking Liu Kang about to come from the left and, you know, ready, fight. You know what I'm saying, y'all, they feel that way when the shit started, I'm like, oh, we about to scrap, nigga, let me know, nigga, we about to, shit, this shit sound like some fight music right here, bro, like, so I'm just like, okay, you know, I'm open to it, let's fuck with it, but then, like, you know, it got a little repetitive, sounds like some shit that should belong in Step Up. I don't think I really like Vince on that track. So track 9 and track 10 were just eh. I think those other tracks he fit well, but I felt like right there was just a little too upbeat for him. That's what I think, you know, a little too upbeat. Track 11, back, bag, pack, bag, back. Tell the 1% to suck my dick because we all know. Real shit. So then what, the big fish theory is about the government, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's the big theory there, you know, like, you know, just how the US is run by the top 5%. Okay, I can fuck with that one. So this track right here, man, I definitely liked it, man. Like I said, you see, I felt like Party People, it was a bit sped up for him. You didn't really intertwine with his flow really well, but I felt like Bag Back was a really good track. You know, it wasn't too fast, and he was actually riding the beat very well. So I fuck with that one. I definitely like that one. Track 12, Rain Come Down. I feel like these last four tracks have been like the motherfucking boss fights of a goddamn, you know, game. You know what I'm talking about? Y'all know what I'm talking about. The boss fight, y'all get to the last boss, that bitch be... Sun go down. Oh, $5. When the shake go round.
Don't you dream of how I feel to be in love? Ooh. Would you think you need a bus? Don't drown in the brown, just
ooh, he's out to be in with a waiter. Will the sun go down? Alright, man, my opinions on this album, man. Look here, man. Contender. It is a contender. Top 10. First of all, it caught my attention with the first two tracks how we came in. You know, Crabs in the Bucket was a little different. Like I said, it had that techno vibe. Like, I feel like I was in a rave club, or as I say to my friends, that club, you know what I'm saying? I felt like just with that, he won me over. Like I said, man, it's all a risk. You know, whatever you do, it's a risk in life. You know, whether you know what I'm saying? Like, whether you're going to invest in something crazy, whether you're going to do something different, whether you're going to do it this way, whether you're going to do it that way. In life, man, you gotta take risks. You know, sometimes it'll be successful, sometimes they fail, sometimes they don't. So I felt like this project right here, at least from my listens, you know, when I listen to Prima Donna, Hell Can Wait, Summertime 06, I definitely felt like this was his album to experiment on. Like, this was something different, something we never heard from him before. Maybe we've heard it from other artists, but not from Vince Staples himself. I felt like, you know, you could even say it was kind of mainstream, but at the same time it wasn't. He was still getting his message out. He still kept the lyrics real, he still kept it conscious, you know, he's still talking about some real shit, and you know, the album still had a concept. For me, I mean, I still didn't pick up that concept. I think it's about, you know, the government and, like, you know, the higher ups, and how we're just the little fish, and, you know, the big fish own the world, own the country, own us. And I think that's what I feel like. But yeah, man, like, it just had an old school feel. I definitely liked it. Having artists like Kendrick Lamar on Yeah Right, you know, it didn't even say featuring Kendrick Lamar, but featuring Kendrick Lamar on Yeah Right, that was a good track. I like how he slowed it down too on 745. That was my favorite track on there. And then Yeah Right was second. And then I like he sped it up. Two tracks I probably didn't like was Ammo and Party People, just because I felt like, you know, the beats were too fast for him. And, you know, he really didn't ride the beat well. But other than that, I mean, all these tracks on here were really, you know, well put together. 10 out of 12, that's, you know, you can't beat that, man. You know, you're gonna have one of those two tracks that some people don't like. A lot of people probably like that, you know, Party People, Sam. Well, just for me, I didn't like that. I like what he's doing here, man. You know, just something different. Something different that worked out for him, because he sounds good doing it. You know, the world we live in now with all these, like, EDM concerts and festivals and how that shit's taking over the world. Yes, EDM and all that techno shit is taking over the world. They have festivals everywhere now in the goddamn country. Everywhere you go, the festivals are bringing in millions and millions of revenue every year. So, I mean, you can say what you want, but Calvin Harris ain't making motherfucking $300 million for no goddamn reason. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's here. And I see how some of these artists, some of that artists in the rap game are, like, accustomed to that. You know, like, I can see, because, you know, it's smart. But at the same time, they're still getting their message around. See, I feel like if you still can keep to yourself, you stay true to yourself, but you can experiment, as long as you stay true to yourself, it's all good with me, man. So I definitely fucks with this, my favorite Vince Staples project. I definitely agree with it. Big Fish Theory is a must listen for this year. So let me know how y'all feel in the comments below, what y'all think, what y'all didn't like. I know everybody's favorite track is probably Party People, because that's the track I dislike, and apparently I dislike every track that everybody likes. So, you know, I'm not including everybody though, you know, even though I am supposed to be including everybody. Whatever though. Let me know how y'all feel about all the tracks down below. Let me know what was y'all favorite. Let me know what y'all didn't like. I know a lot of y'all are Vince Staples fans and hardcore stands and out there. So let me know what y'all liked. Let me know y'all opinions and I'll talk to y'all, read it. Whoever has the funniest comment, I'll pin it like I always do. Hey, but this has been your boy Dev. Don't forget, like, comment, subscribe, share. Let's get the video to 1,000 likes, man, so I get the next video out. And yeah, until the next time, we out.